All right, guys, this week on Nick's Collectible Creations, we're going to be taking a look at the train museum, the Model Railroad Museum in Greeley, Colorado. We're going to be taking a look at this beautiful layout behind me, and we'll also get to have a behind-the-scenes look at this place. We're staying until close, so don't want to miss this. It's going to be a long video, but it's definitely worth the watch. Thank you, everybody. Here we go. Changing to nighttime, I guess, or nighttime scenery. That's pretty cool. This is a nice Christmas village here. We're taking a look at the Colorado Train Museum in Greeley, Colorado. This is right at the entrance when you walk into this place. So that's what we're taking a look at right now. Hope you guys enjoy this video of the Model Railroad Museum tour. As usual, this is an as-is-you're-here experience.
Okay. Fine.
so far. But yeah, Bill, make it an office to get. Okay. I hope everybody's got all one of each. Okay. All right. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, you only have one.
Good luck.
Yes, sir.
Want to look at another card?
I don't think he comes back.
All right, guys, This is a big place that we're looking at today. Lots of modeling ideas for all you guys, including myself. Get some detail with some of these trees here up close.
Been on that track for a while?
Oh, yeah. See, that was funny.
They ran the locomotive this morning. We ran flawlessly.
Huh?
We ran the locomotive this morning. We ran flawlessly.
It just wouldn't respond to anything there. Yeah.
You think of the ground layout?
No, I'm going to put it right over here. That guy. I'm going to put it right here. Take it back to you and take off. What do you think of this?
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
Some shots in here that look realistic.
and he started to cry.
You gotta start that for us, huh?
Yeah. Like, this is so cool. You know, and then he started that fire. So, I think that's so awesome.
Did you see the one on the other side?
No.
The fireworks started. And you can even hear the fireworks. Okay. Yeah, those are the two smoky ones.
It's about my length of train right there, I suppose. I wrapped my whole room right there. A squeaky wheel on that one.
Did you find that truck up here, Ed? Did you find him? Huh? No. That's what I'm looking for.
Oh,
I'm hoping I'm going to steer this guy.
Dino the dinosaur in the lake there. Didn't see that in the last run by.
Not in the way.
there too.
As the story goes, there's a picture of that thing first. We were working on it.
Thank you.
Alright guys, we're starting to get mostly through this now. Hope y'all are still with me. Hope you're enjoying the video. Please like, share, subscribe, comment, all that fun stuff. This is a really awesome place, guys. I hope you guys are liking the video. This is being shot in 4K. It's the best I can do with my camera here. So we're on stabilizers and everything else. So it's not terribly well lit in here, but it's not horrible. So hopefully trying to get it as crisp as possible and slow pan. So I hope you guys are sticking with it, and we're going to continue on. Oh, here, there it is. Yep, the old Rio Grande.
We've got the moon and we've got two green lights. And we're going to be entering the tunnel of love. All those last trees.
Where is it at? That one?
No, this building to right the front of you there.
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
No.
This button.
Oh, that's...
First responders are cutting. Pretty soon you'll hear some popping and cracking. And the fireworks start to explode. Unless they don't have a fuel up.
Oh, I hear it now. Yep, there's the smoke.
Yep, there we go.
That's pretty realistic smoke. Fireworks. Shot, burned up, blew up. Burned up, blew up combination. Thank you. doesn't really have a smell to the smoke. I wonder if they make fireworks scented smoke. The thing goes on for a while. There's all these boats they got back here. It's kind of an interesting little corner. No public access, but we can get pretty close to this area, the shipyards. Makeshift shipyards, kind of cool. Now we're going to go in the red caboose here, guys. Want to see what we can see in there. That's pretty cool. They got it opened up, unlike the Forney Museum did. You see, they actually got these opened up in here. Looks like pretty much the same caboose they had over there, though. So this one actually has windows in it. So let's go ahead and get up here and see what this is like. Some pretty narrow stairs. Looks like they got all kinds of neat stuff in here. We're just gonna have a look-see. This is a really nicely restored or preserved, I don't know, but this is a really beautiful caboose they've got here at this museum. This is definitely much better than the one at Forney. That one was nice too, but you couldn't get in it. This one you can get in it, it's got windows. I mean, it looks complete, guys. Or it's been restored to that fashion, but I like these beds right here. Really, these cabooses have a pretty good amount of space in them, really. I mean, you could live in one of these pretty comfortably, actually. This is really pretty nice, guys. I really like this. I can see why people like cabooses. The caboose, the caboose, the cabosse. It's very nice in here, guys. It's pretty cool. That scale actually says something, although I'm sure it's broke, but at least it displays something of relative importance, I guess. I don't know. But, yeah, this is pretty sweet, guys. It's got a nice old-fashioned smell to it. I don't know how else to describe it, but let's see if there's... Oh, they got these drilled, screwed in. That's too bad. This is a nice caboose, guys. They did a nice job on this. Very, very pleasant place to be. Alright, guys, let's move on and go upstairs, I guess, because that's about all we've got to do left is to go to the upper level and look down. So here we go. I guess we do have a couple more layouts to film, too. And we'll do a nice pan shot of this place in general here. So we're still up on the caboose. Nice area to be. It's beautiful signs around here. This is a nice pan around this place here. And then we're going to go to the upper level up there. And take a look at those trains and those cases too, I think, guys. So again, hopefully y'all have stayed with me this long. I know it's a long video, but there's a lot to see here, guys. So we're going to go take a look at where they park the trains, guys. So special behind the scenes here.
This is the end of the journey on the main railway. So back here is where we park the trains and we start them. So we take you guys back there to the road. So you have the road. Road is the main, road is the siding. So he's going to throw me on this siding.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
So the yellow light indicates. case this switches
over. Oh, yeah, yeah.
And so he's going to throw me in this, which is the bypass, so that I can go all the way to the other room.
Oh.
It's got to be the fairport.
Are these Athrun RTRs?
Jake would know.
Okay. They don't quite look like Athrun Genesis, but...
Here's one of the trains that just started out and he's going through the maze.
Going through the maze, yeah. Staging tracks, yeah.
These are all the eastbound trains. Right now there's only one out. The Trailblazer, which is a twin of mine.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
And these are the staging tracks. These are the staging tracks for people bringing their own equipment.
Okay, okay.
This gentleman here has got all these game cars. And the passenger train there, these are all belong to the museum.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
This one is called the Glowworm. I call it the Happy Hooker.
Yeah.
And it's about 80 cars long. It's the longest train that belongs to the museum.
So you just leave them hooked up and then send them out whenever they're...
Well, I'll show you how the process runs and begins when I get around here.
Now, isn't some... I've heard some of this is automated. Is that...
Friday and Saturday are all engineers and the dispatcher. Sunday is generally what they call a docent, and it's run by computers.
Mm-hmm.
And they can run four trains both ways.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the kids, when they see these, they think, are those missiles? So, you know, those are the front end of a harvester.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I can see where they think that.
Yeah, they do. First time I looked, they look like they were missiles. I'm on track number 7. So I'm not sure all my switches are green.
Trying to get him
before you get him. Wow. This is huge. You going to
make
another run yet?
Nope.
I think it's getting a little too late.
Yeah, it's 3:30. You got to really push it down.
Most of these trains are similar to the ones all over, just a mirror image. This one doesn't have quite as many of the orange cars.
Mm-hmm.
The passenger trains over here are going to go on to the museum. This one is an ore train. And so he can ask for permission to go to Coos Bay and drop below.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll show you that when we get through here.
Wow.
Some of these trains, the dispatcher will ask, when you ask for permission to go out, we'll ask, are you going to switch? And so there are several places on the layout that you can do switching. You drop 10 cars and pick up 10, or you drop 20 and pick up 10.
You guys doing the way bill cards and all that stuff? You doing the way bill cards and all that?
You have a card that tells you, you know, which switches to throw and what to do. And then when you're through, you have to ask permission to get back on the layout and switch one or one at Lakeview or some other switch on the other side. The other way you can tell which trains are out is you can see the light on the track.
Oh, okay, yeah. That's a clever idea, that little LED right there on the track. Okay.
That's the one that wakes up the locomotive. You see this bank of toggles? That controls the power to the trains. These are all the westbound trains.
Yeah, they're still all sitting there idling.
Throw it off.
Okay.
And then you have to clear it out of this, because if somebody picks this up to come back here, it still says 85.
Yeah, it's still set for your locomotive.
So you have to enter a new loco, you enter zero, enter, and it wipes it out. And then clear.
So you guys have to be pretty well coordinated.
Well, you have to you go through four four trips to qualify. And usually the first time you go, someone else drives the train and tells you, explains all of this, what to do. When you start, it's just the reverse of the process. You turn it on.
Okay.
You program your loco in, you check whether the horn, the bell, and the headlight are working. And then you get on the horn and say, train 141, or dispatch, this is train 141, 1,800 feet long. Request permission to pull up to the light at Fairport. And then he'll reply in the positive or negative, if we've got too many going. Or he's got one in front of me that wants to go out. Like today, I was ready to start mine, and I noticed the gentleman had the Union Pacific train. And I said, well, why don't, you're a passenger, why don't you go first? Because you're going to go faster. You don't want to be behind me.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I had this one this morning. It was the first train I took out, and it moves pretty slow because it's, as you can see, it's
goes all the way down
almost
there.
20, I think it's 2,500 feet long. The one I just finished with is only 1,800. Now that's scale feet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's what we
still pretty long.
The reason you have to tell the dispatcher the length of your train is sometimes you'll have to have two trains on the same siding before the train coming the other direction, and so he needs to know whether he's got enough room to put both of you.
Oh, wow. So the longest train is how many feet?
The glowworm. Yeah, the glowworm. He's probably about 3,200 feet, I think.
3,200?
He's got 80 cars. You guys can come this way, because I'm going to take you out to Coos Bay to show you where this load goes.
One set of water bottles.
Yeah,
those are the lanes.
3,250.
No, he's just about 3,200. You usually tell him the longer of the two. Because right here he's 31, so he's got a couple of centimeters.
Looks like this is all Code 100 Atlas back here.
Yeah, I think so. It's all, the whole layout was built on the cork. The turnouts on the main line are all 12s. They're fast
So if you're throwing on a siding, you really don't need to slow down. Just go on the siding. That's the year of the railroad. And the model railroad. They tried to do the prototype railroad and the year of that railroad or the era.
Season, year, yeah. Right. Some people get specific, like June 12, 1973,
yeah.
You know.
I'm not that familiar with the origination of the layout. It's over 10 years old.
Yeah.
And it took 5 years to build it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
And these kind of trees, the fir trees, there's 16,000 of them. And they're all hand-built. They're a dowel rod with kind of that steel wool that's on the bottom of this big polishers.
Yeah.
And this is what, are you from Greeley?
No, but I've been down there for a long time, the old Montfort meat plant.
Yeah, Montfort, you know, owned the packing plant, and then he sold it to Swift.
Yeah,
and
Swift,
and
that's who it was, yeah.
Swift had the big bust
of illegals, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So JBS bought him out, and rather than mess with trying to prove whether they were legal or not, they started hiring refugees. And so we have people from Somalia, Myanmar, Eritrea, Eastern Africa, and they're all legal because they're refugees escaping the civil wars in those countries.
Right.
And so that's why you'll see many of that ethnicity in town. Really was a problem for the school district because they all speak different languages. Some of them have never been in school. They've been in a refugee camp. You know, they've been born there. And they come here, and so some of the older kids struggle. The younger kids, you know, brings them along and acclimate to what life is like in America.
Oh wow!
Some of the refugees, they had to learn that there is a right side of the road and a left side of the road. And the markers in the middle mean don't cross.
Yeah, stay within the lines. The lines are your friends.
And the deciduous trees, there's about 9,000 of them.
Yeah.
And see, that's where the ore train will come through there.
Uh-huh.
And it'll come back here. And these are models that we built. And these are actually, they are radio controlled. They can take them out.
I remember hearing about that, yeah.
So here's the empty one. So when they bring that train back here that's got the ore, they'll drop them here, and then they'll pick up these empties, and then they'll take them back around the layout and park the train in staging.
Mm-hmm.
Then they got to come back here with a magnet and they'll pull up all the loads.
Oh, really?
And take them back
and
refill the cars.
I would have thought someone would have built a dumper by now.
No, they just...
Well, that was really cool. Thank you.
This is another model that can be radio controlled.
Uh-huh.
I saw that from afar, but when I was up close, I had it.
Yeah, you can see all this from the balcony, but you really don't get the flavor of what's back here.
Right.
Thank you. Wow.
Now, have they ever actually taken these out on the lake?
Yeah, there's some pictures.
Oh, okay.
One of them has both ships. It's got the Norfolk and then one of them.
Okay.
I think that's the Tampa in Chester.
Okay.
And the other one is the Yakima Bay, and that's one of the bays around the Oregon coast. We did an 8-day trip out there this summer.
This will be a good book for modeling the different eras of freight cars. I get pictures of all the different. It's only $3. Only $3 for that. Probably charge a lot more than that on eBay. Alright guys, we're just about ready to end the video here. Bob was the guy that gave us the back tour of this place, the behind the curtain shop of this place here, and look at all the staging and all that stuff like that. So sure do appreciate Bob for letting us take a moment to look and see how this place works behind the scenes. The man behind the curtain, so to speak, there. The wizard behind the Oz. And we're just about ready to end this video up here, guys. We're taking a look at these trains and the cases on the upstairs level here. Some of the signage they got up here. We're basically staying till closing here, so they close at 4 p.m. Mountain Daylight Time. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday they're open. So you guys want to come down here sometime and have at. If you've never been here before, definitely going to be coming back myself at some point. And I doubt there's going to be a whole lot different, but we'll get to see the layout a little bit better. And I probably won't be videoing the next time. Well, we'll see. I don't know. So that's going to end it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you again right here on Nick's Collectible Creations. Peace out. Like, subscribe, share, comment, and all that fun stuff, guys. See you again. Bye-bye.